From above, a tragic and devastating view of the old town of Homs. More than 2 years of intense battles, a brutal siege, and the use of heavy weapons have laid waste to a city with a history of more than 4,000 years. As the people here begin to pick up the pieces, the Syrian government says now is the time for reconciliation between those who supported the rebels and the supporters of the government. But we managed to speak to an opposition supporter who refused to be identified, but says the rebel evacuation of Homs was a bitter defeat. Of course, we're happy that there's a ceasefire, the person says, but at the same time, we are devastated that we didn't achieve the victory to get rid of the regime. The Khalid ibn Walid Mosque used to be right on the front line. It was badly damaged during the fighting here. Now, for the first time in about a year, prayers are held here. As a show of reconciliation, the government invited leaders of the Christian community to attend as well. But speaking to the opposition supporter, it's clear the rift between many Sunni Muslims, who mostly side with the rebels, and the Alawites and Christians, who are mostly on the government side, will take years to bridge. There's a major distrust now between us, the person says. Maybe in 300 years or so we'll be able to live in peace together again, but for now, it's not possible. While Homs lay in ruins, the government says the fighting here is now over. But that's only partially true. This is what the city sounds like in the evening hours and at night. Heavy explosions and gunfire coming from here. This is Al-Wa'ir, on the outskirts of Homs, the last place still held by the rebels. Syria's army says most of those fighting for the opposition are not Syrian, but the rebel supporter tells me that's not the case. Most of those fighting are our sons and brothers, the person says. They're not foreigners, they are from our families, and we support them. It seems most people in Homs are in favor of the truce between the rebels and the government, but it's also clear that the underlying issues that led to the conflict in this town have yet to be resolved. Frederik-Pleitgen, CNN, Homs, Syria.